It's the program. We're on TV once again, once a day, every day. Turn on the machines and then we start talking.
We'll be here for an hour.
You have that...
That was...
Sunday tape is rewinded?
Yeah, it's so... Rewind.
I'm going to do that. We're going to do this thing. We're going to do this building thing. I was watching, remember where it started doing this building, the tape thing the other day.
Yeah.
But today, we're going to do it more, and then we're going to get it more organized, and it'll take like maybe a month, and we'll fill the screen with
different... Oh my god, Teddy!
What?
That's going to be so scary. It's going to trip out everyone.
It's going to be scary. Who's going to... Are you going to be scared?
No. I mean,
no?
Yeah. No, I don't know.
Maybe a little bit?
You're just a big liar, Carl.
About being scared?
What? Me?
Yeah.
No,
not
I'm
scared.
Not scared.
Not scared. You're tough.
Yeah.
You're too tough to be scared.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Let's see. How are you?
Okay.
Did we say the thing about being on the streets? I mean, or on the program and starting?
Yeah.
And things like that? Did we say that stuff already?
Yeah.
Did we?
But we could certainly do it again.
Well, we don't have to do that, but,
I do believe we said it once, but...
How are you? What do you do? What did you see on the streets today,
bro?
Hey,
it's the program. Once again, once a day, every day, we turn on the machines and we talk for an hour.
Here we go. What'd you see on the streets, Carl? Things?
Yeah. I got my car in to be, oil changed. And then from that, I went to, groups in downtown. And, I did a little bit in the check-in in terms of, I'm talking about, the art that I'm doing, in groups, yeah, I mean, it was, just...
Hey, a phone call!
Ooh, yeah. Oh. You're really cutting out there, bro. Click, click, click. Click,
whoa.
Click.
Is this from yesterday?
Yeah.
We sound so crazy. Why do we sound so crazy? What's happening?
I don't know.
There's no sound on yesterday's tape? Is that? No, this is probably not the beginning yet.
No, it's... He just said, you just said that, got a phone call.
What, yesterday was silent somehow? Uh-oh, maybe the headphones are not doing us well. I'm gonna go look at this thing back here. Did you see that woman at groups?
No.
Alright, well, anyone else? What else, Carl? I'm gonna fix this.
I took myself to, back home, and, one of the more interesting things, about, the art that I'm doing, I talked, briefly about, getting an art that would, upload images to a off-site server in the cloud or something like that. So this is a Russian kind of uploading it to
What is happening back there?
We're cutting out, bro. You need to get on a new antenna, bro.
Why are we cutting out so much? That's weird.
Yeah, it's 2016. We can't use 1980s.
Is that why we're cutting out? It's because of the 80s?
Crash. Bam, bam.
I wonder if this is what we sounded like yesterday, too.
Scary.
Yeah. It might be that way. This might be what we sound like right now. Something I don't even know about. Why is it sounding like this? I don't know why.
Well, if it's playing off camera like this, then maybe
on the phone.
Like we should be able to hear it on the TV somewhat. Maybe the headphones are down.
And that was a good program.
I gotta move something back here.
That was a good program.
What?
Probably in. I don't remember most of it.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Oh yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I want to be able to.
It's depressing though. We lost an hour in the past again. We're always moving through time.
Are you depressed? I'm okay with it.
No. We must not be okay. We must, you know, get into a DeLorean and say,
No.
Carl, Kitty, you can't use that tape. That tape is dependent on the future.
I think we must relax and just say that it's okay and everything's fine and nothing's wrong. That's what we must do.
Okay.
Good.
If you say
I
so.
I say so.
Okay. this program is actually a couple of different variants that now that have been inspired. The first one I guess was called Prisma, and then there's another program like called Pikazoo, which is PIKAZO,
mm-hmm.
and people can download these apps on their phone, and these apps allow people to kind of change the picture that they shot to fit the motif, the screen or the color variations and whatnot.
Pick-a-doo.
Famous paintings like The Scream, Vincent van Gogh's Starry Night, Cezanne, Jackson Pollock, you know, just a variety of different obvious, significant, interesting picture-like embellishments or whatever, painting and embellishments. And there's, I went to related Photoshop related just like filters or whatever. It's a really interesting, I guess, how imaging technology has kind of grown by leaps and bounds, you know, through the five past years or the two past years or whatever. Prisma is a rather new app that I don't think was around, you know, the last time that it was, you know, had a serious attempt at, you know, working at Arts Walk. And so this deep generator, I don't want to say deep web, because I think that's kind of related to hacking or whatever, like a or is that the dark web? Anyway, these filters or whatever have gone on beyond to be like a filter of photo, like Picasso or Cezanne or Jackson Pollock or whatever, that there are obvious like sharpening filters as well. So I don't know, it's almost when I see this, I kind of get like maybe a shot in the arm in terms of like artistic expression, and it's so good, you know. I'm not, you know, it's I'm really looking forward to Arts Walk in the fall.
Good.
So yeah, that's basically I guess what I saw on the streets today.
What about Democratic meetings?
Oh yes. Well, I was like going over to the courthouse, and I was
what's at the courthouse?
So the courthouse had like a meeting, but there was like maybe 10 or 15 people there, and I was kind of feeling kind of awkward to drop in just 2 minutes late or whatever. So I thought, you know, okay, well, maybe John Webster is not there. If he is there, then he's more of a diehard sort of politician person than I am, basically. You know, wanting to get into politics.
Uh-huh.
If he's going to a meeting with, like, 10, 12, 15
other
people.
He wants to go
people.
To those, yeah.
But, you know, I mean, I've been kind of geeky myself. Sat through most of City Hall council meeting where they were talking about like sidewalk improvements.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, there's the block towards between here and the city block that basically has the childhoods and gallery. There's a block between this one and where we're on State and Capitol, that this the sidewalk walking towards or coming away from the boardwalk was really bad, and so they the city council was talking about all these different sidewalk improvements and whatnot, and taking a look at their Google Map drawings over, you know, they drew over Google images, you know, from like a satellite view of Olympia, all these different improvements that need to be made to downtown core sidewalks and whatnot, and so yeah, I could kind of understand that maybe John Webster would be the same sort of person that would, you know, sit through maybe a 10 or, you know, 15 person meeting, but I didn't really think so. So
oh, okay.
I was like, whatever, maybe I'll go to his place.
Oh, you want to hunt him down?
I went to hunt him down, you know, and I was like, oh, you're actually there. Hey, John.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Do you need some company? And so I'm basically sat with them for about 45 minutes.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, so after I was, like, gone to... Well,
so he's alive. He just hasn't been answering his phone.
Yeah. His phone is, like, different. He said that he had a different phone.
Yeah, I heard he had a new phone.
Yeah, and so I basically called him. I added him as a contact and rung once, and he's like, who's that? And I hung up the phone quickly, and I said, well, maybe that's Kenny. I want to know
who that is. We're gonna call him, I guess, and see if it works.
Yeah,
John, where are you? Your phone's messed up. I didn't think you were gonna go over to his place and find him, Carl. I thought you were gonna see him at a meeting or something.
Well, yes, but he wasn't there, obviously. I found him down over at his place.
Yeah, you went to the meetings first, though, I guess, huh?
Well, yeah, but you know, the meeting was basically not very interesting, and there had been a counter where they would have like name, address, you know, like form thing to fill out.
Maybe John's ignoring us, so that's why I'm on the phone. I think is what
your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. 3-6-0-1-1 is not available at the tone. Please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hey John, you there? Did you try his voicemail? Does he have one of those one that is out loud?
I guess we're trying it now.
Hey John, can you hear me?
Hello.
I don't think you can right now though. I don't even think you check your voicemails, really. Maybe you do. You can call us back, John. Yeah. Carl went to visit you.
Yeah. And that's a good thing.
Yeah, sure. He could use a visit, I think.
Yeah.
Let's call Freddy the producer.
Yeah.
Here it goes. Let's see. Where is it? What do we got? Over there, are we doing any more of that stuff? Did we look at all those tapes?
No.
Drag race.
Drag racing, but I need to rewind.
That was drag racing. Drag racing was TV, or it was like ESPN or something.
Well,
what else is there?
Okay, fine.
Isn't there another home one?
I mean, no.
Maybe around there, or down there, not on.
Well, if there is, I need to eject this tape.
Oh, yeah, but isn't there one down there somewhere?
Well, yeah, I could search for it.
Hey, you've reached Freddy Dobler. I can't come to the phone right now.
I guess we can't really
but
eject
if you
the
leave
other
me
tape.
A nice message, then I will call you back as soon as I can. Thanks
so
a lot.
Time to do that? I mean, I don't know.
Hey, Freddy, it's the program. You can call us back. You have, like, 35 minutes.
So I can eject the tape, though?
Not for drag race.
No, I mean, no, for this one.
Then we're gonna look at that one?
Well, it's either home 97 or 99 or, I don't know.
All right,
let's look at it.
Let's look at it.
Okay, all right.
Here we go. Home 90, whatever. Well, there's nothing. No, this is a movie. That's like maybe Space Jam. All right. Nope. We'll go back to the other one. Here it goes. We're gonna go back to the thing where you're up there in the corner, not the other thing. But it's also let's play the dice game.
Yeah.
What happens here? We're gonna get out a pen. We're gonna write down numbers on our hands between 1 and 6.
Timmy on his bicycle with Charlotte.
I'll put on Sunday. Back to Sunday.
Okay.
Your levels built up for the next month.
Levels.
We're gonna build up Carl's levels.
Levels.
Yeah, how many levels? We're gonna get to like level 1.
Levels.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So is that like?
We're gonna get to level like 12.
Is that like where the?
You're gonna be so powerful.
Yeah, like Padlins or whatever.
Pokemon.
Dungeons and Dragons. You know.
Pokemon.
No. Pokemon.
You're gonna be level 12 Carlzard.
I not played Pokemon.
You seem to know so much about Pokemon.
So when people play Pokemon Go, I basically, you know, what character, why are you trying to catch them all? What character
Why don't you
what?
Try it? Have you even tried it? You like your phone?
Yeah, for art.
You're knocking it before you try. You never did. You were playing that DC game on it for so long. I think you like it for
Marvel.
Other things.
I played Marvel Contest of Champions.
You played both of them.
I still have them, actually.
Yeah, but you can get Pokemon.
Well, these characters I know a little bit more about than just like Pikachu.
But you can learn. You can learn about
it's
them.
It's a generational thing, Kenny.
You can learn about them. What are we doing? We're playing a dice game. Yeah, here we go. Who's going to win the dice game? Oh, yeah. We'll just roll them. All right, here we go. Number one!
Yeah, step that with pie. Thank you very much. I need some pie in my hole.
I don't know why it's cutting in and out on in the past. That's weird. I hope it's not doing that in the present. And
what about the future?
Yeah, the future.
Oh my god.
If it's doing that in the future, that'd be really weird. Well, I mean, I guess tomorrow, but I hope it's not doing it right now, though. I think it might be doing it right now. And we gotta listen to it off the headphones.
So hello.
Try to hear for it. And
hi. You hear me?
We're not in that. Not in the headphones. Like in the. It's on the TV, so it's like easier.
Do you hear me?
Yeah. Oh yeah. I can
on
hear
the
it.
TV.
Yeah, I can hear it on the TV. I think it's going.
It's weird.
It's weird. We got no messages today.
All right, then I guess it's time for me to go home and do more of my art on my phone.
Yeah, it's all about the messages on the phone, huh?
Yeah. But I mean, if there's no messages, there's no program, right?
Yeah, viewers out there.
No, that's not how it works, Carl.
Viewers, you can call the number, leave some messages on the thing.
Who am I? Why am I here? Exactly. Let's figure that one out.
You need to do that one first.
It looks like everyone else is going to roll the ones. At 11:30 p.m. this episode taped on the same weekday the previous week. You're watching this episode at 2 a.m. this episode taped on the same day of the month of the previous year. You can also watch any episode of the program on YouTube.com. Anyone can come on the program, especially you. We rely on the community for content, so give us a call at 360-836-4384 and leave a message. We'll play a message on the next episode of the program and we'll call you back. Thanks for your time and welcome back to the program. You're watching your daily air with me, it's Arlon. Jesus.
You hit something?
Yeah, I hit the tape.
Hitting the tapes. What are you doing?
Yeah. You're watching your daily hour with me. It's our long hyper life.
So what's it's the down season, Carl, for the president. Right? We're not going to get back into that for a while? Or when is that?
Oh, no. That's kind of interesting that you would bring up this situation now.
Yeah.
I think... I don't know. I don't know what's going on out there. I want to kind of, break, maybe the glass ceiling or the glass wall.
The glass steagle?
No, not glass steagle. But the glass ceiling or the glass wall in order to figure out what's going on the other side of that camera. It's going to shock me like it's going to shock you. Apparently, Hillary has a 15-point lead over Donald Trump right now.
Yeah.
And I don't understand it, because like last week they were both at 40 even, I thought, or week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago, and it's like, wow, now she's at 15-point ahead lead, and it's like all of the internet, from what little I saw of social media, I didn't even you know, log into Facebook, but the breaking news that is on, that comes through banners on my phone.
How do these points work?
I don't know, and I'm just...
Oh, yeah, there's like, Hillary has points! Ah, 15 points! Ah, how'd you get so many points so fast?
Well, she's you know, I guess they're doing push-pulling, but when...
What's that?
It's like when people call on the telephone, and who do you want?
Oh,
you
know,
do you want Hillary or Trump? And I'm like, oh, I want Trump. No, I want Hillary. You know.
Who's the phones? Are these people with landlines?
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe cell phones or whatnot. I honestly, I don't know what the metrics that they are to calculate this. But the reason I say to break the, you know, the divider that divides, you know, the people from, you know, the backroom deals or whatever, I think maybe that they're trying to convince the American public that Hillary is much more of a presidential candidate than Donald Trump is.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of somewhat of an Orwellian kind of point of view that the government is maybe doing. You know, it's like, hey, you want Hillary? Yes, you want Hillary. Hillary is in a 15-point lead. You know, Hillary, Hillary, Hillary. And I'm just like, I don't understand. One, maybe that's going to work, although with the rise of political candidates and social media and the television to be the only source of news is kind of like at an all-time low. I don't know whether or not to believe, you know, Hillary's lead at all. I think that maybe they're still, you know, breaking even between the two of them, you know, within 5 or 7 points between them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that it's not 15. But, you know, whatever happens in the future, you know, if we're looking at Hillary, President Hillary versus President Donald, you know, it's not, you know, going to be my fault because I don't really want to vote for either one of them, really.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How do these points? I wonder what these points are. They're shooting hoops.
Well, we could call various media.
Yeah.
You
can
know,
you tell
like
me how points
CNN.
Are? CNN. What are the points? So CNN's the people that are awarding these points.
Yeah.
Oh, so maybe we should just award our own points.
Well.
How many points? Today.
It's gonna abstain from the two top political candidates on this side of the
maybe
couch.
We should roll the dice.
Oh.
For Hillary.
Oh.
And Trump every day.
Okay.
And see who's in the lead.
Okay. Yeah, that's all right. That's I'm going to go along with that. So
yeah, all right.
Yeah, so who's going to do highs and who's going to do lows?
I guess we should roll for that too. I guess who goes first though?
Okay.
Who goes first? That's a hard one. How do you choose these things? We're gonna...
You flip a coin?
Yeah, day one. This is gonna be day one of...
We could say that Hillary's being kind of in, you know, like a...
Oh, 0 beers left. Do you see this?
Yeah.
This one's over. So now it's day one of how many... When do they announce the president winning?
November.
Day one.
So November is 3 months away, basically. No, actually, the election, I think, is...
I think...
It's now going to be, like, 3 months from now.
Hillary
gets... You know, we keep on saying 3 months, but I think the election is actually November 7th, and today is August 8th.
Hillary and Donald...
Yeah, we got a scoreboard there now.
All right. Here we go. Hillary is evens. Donald is odds.
All right.
All right, here we go. Day one. We're announcing, we're going to do the presidency thing here. Oh. All right, here we go. Hey, wait, Hillary's even? What did we say? This is so quiet right now. Why is it so quiet? What's going on? Weird things are happening. Well, whatever. Here we go. What is it? 3! Donald! Right? Donald with 1! That means...
I don't know if we are going odds or even, but I'll accept that Donald is an even candidate.
No, Hillary is even, Donald is odds.
Yeah, Hillary is even, Donald is kind of the odd political outsider that no one really expected to be in the... Hillary would have been kind of a given.
Hillary, 1. Donald, up. 0-1. Maybe, how many days is it going to be? Over 100?
Yeah, it's like...
not over.
30 times 3, basically. I would think. I don't know if every month, you know, has like 30 days between now and the... But the November election, I believe, is on the 7th.
Should we give?
And today's August 8th. So.
And we're saying, I guess, that we only believe in the two-party system. No chance of anybody else winning right now, right?
That would be true. I haven't been on social media to know what's Jill Stein's stake in, and that would be really interesting if they keep on telling, you know, the American public that Jill Stein isn't breaking up beyond 2 or 5% or whatever, when she actually is polling in a far excessive number. I'm kind of want more analysis of these poll numbers myself, so maybe I'm gonna have to get myself onto social media by whenever this program airs or tapes tomorrow to figure that one out. There's independent polling, sure. Independent polling might be talking to other people than of course the polling that, you know, is like James Zogby or whatever, CNN Gallup poll or New York Times poll or whatever, that these more mainstay polls are asking of their respondents.
James Zogby.
Yeah. Yeah, he's a pollster. I guess he was popular in predicting maybe an election, between Bush and Gore. Or yeah. Maybe it went into the opposite direction of miscalculating Gore's win or something like that. But he's one of the more known people out there or pollsters, polling organizations like Gallup, CNN or New York Times or whatever.
I'm looking at old messages here. What do I call these old messages?
Huh?
Archival messages.
Yeah. Good.
I think this might be Elias.
Hey, that's up. in the room, Ava.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up with the Halloween party? You smoke, you drink.
That sounds like her.
What's happening?
It's real windy and... Elias is quiet.
What's up? Get me in the room, Ava.
Yeah, it is back up. Elias left a lot of messages back here. If that is her.
Have you put me on your insanity profile yet? Calling you like a freaking weirdo. I still don't know your name.
I don't know whether to be shocked or horrified or happy.
Horrified.
Amused.
Horrified. Yeah, there you go.
What's up, man?
What's up, Elias?
Not for me, anyway. I answered my phone for you. Oh, it's so uneven right now. Not fair, home.
Yeah, that's uneven.
Elias?
Hillary's leading by 1 point. No, is it? No, it's Donald. It's Donald.
Oh, Donald.
Jesus. It's backwards. The TV is backwards of reality.
What's going on in real life now?
Hillary's leading by 15 points. So.
But how do you get points?
You just delete me?
By asking the right people, I guess.
How many points did they
have? Or it's really skewing, maybe this is going to be a true test whether or not people want to vote for someone that's a loser. That they're trying to use.
So are you going to have an exciting show? You're going to do it.
Yeah, we are having an exciting show.
Did they have points yesterday? How many points did they have yesterday?
I don't know.
Are their points accumulative?
No.
Or each day they have different kinds of points?
No, each day, there's different responders or respondents or...
I know, I'm annoying.
This could be a fly by night polling organization that has Hillary up there by 15 points. I really don't know, but I think it's just my personal opinion that, the big wigs in media and in politics or whatever inflate Hillary's numbers just so that they can. Probably
it's the big wigs.
Some people to vote for Hillary rather than to vote for Trump. Who wants to vote for a loser, basically? But
yeah, speak up, Elias. I can't really hear her. Let's what's the next dice game? Next dice game.
Yes, indeed.
Here we go. Let's play the next dice game.
Your show's not on yet. Wake
me up for your show. What?
Anyway. I'm sorry, Oz.
That we can't hear you.
Here we go. Oh, these are 1 and 6.
Yay, 1 and 6. Look at that. Onesers and sixers, but more of ones.
Onesers and sixers.
Yeah.
All right. We're gonna keep going. Let's play the commercial. We're gonna look at the commercial too.
Right.
Here we go. It's this commercial.
Dude, I don't know why you gotta sit here and be rude and considerate.
Oh, that
wow.
That one was Angry Steve from a long time ago.
God damn it.
Yeah.
Oh. I guess I gotta... There's no audio. I don't hear nothing. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I made a fantastic discovery.
What?
Yesterday.
What? No, you didn't.
I learned that Cyril Shelby is in
this yesterday?
Yeah, Jesus. I mean, maybe we want to watch that again, or maybe we don't. I don't know.
It's the...
Wait.
Ninth.
No, no, that's the ninth.
What?
Are the commercials wrong again?
Wait, go back one more. Where is the,
Is this gonna say 7 or 8? I wonder.
That one's 8? That one says 8, that's supposed to be today, right?
It's... Well, I guess we'll just have to watch this. Just
Friday's commercial
should
be on
in accordance to the... How the numbers say the numbers. So... Today is the 8th. We'll just watch this.
Today's the 8th, right? But this
Fuck
is the
it.
We watched yesterday, though.
No. Well, maybe we'll just have to rewind a little bit.
Wait, what? Which one?
Maybe the commercials are repeating again.
No. This
no.
Wait, so,
I don't know how we managed to see Cheryl Shelby. Although, what was that?
So it should be the one after that last one.
No, I'm
this one is
wondering
number 7.
What was the commercial before this one?
This one's the 7th. And then, yeah, the 7th, and then the...
Yeah.
Oh, this is the same one, though, right?
Yeah, it's... Oh, are we getting weird?
We're getting real weird. Wait,
We're getting weird. I made a fantastic discovery.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus.
Something really weird is happening. Wait, okay. Oh, wait, so we saw that one, and then we went to...
This one.
That one, okay, that was...
Which was yesterday.
Girls in Love.
And then we're gonna see this again.
Alright.
Which is weird.
No, okay, let's watch the next one after this one, then.
Well, then that's gonna be tomorrow.
Well, which one is it, though? We don't know. We gotta see a new one, at least. Either way. That's why we gotta say the day in the commercial now.
Yeah, hey everybody, commercial.
What day is it?
We're here today with Carl. We called McDonald's. We called Redbird and Mr. Gintu.
Redbird. We got to sell hotcakes before noon. Call McDonald's 836-4381. You can be on TV. Just
don't serve
come on
hotcakes before noon.
But I think they can do it now. I think we
they
have
can.
Breakfast.
Hotcakes, cakes whenever you want.
It's gonna be like just like your average diner.
It's hotcakes all the time now.
Yeah.
Whenever you want hotcakes, you can have them.
So that is going to be me again.
Yeah.
When I can eject. So, Sunday. Here we go.
You want hotcakes? No problem. Any time of the day. McDonald's.
Just don't shoot up this place like it was part of the Falling Down movie or something.
Yeah, it's irrelevant now, that whole thing.
Yeah.
That's not happening anymore.
It's scary.
I don't
horrifying.
Know why is the thing cutting out like that?
La 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 la.
Why is it?
La 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 la.
Hey, what are you doing?
I gotta take this. Hello, do you hear me? Yeah, they hear me.
I hear you. What? Are you?
No, I mean with the earphones off. If it's going to TV, then...
Is it working? Did you try it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
No.
Is it working now, though?
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe it's not cutting... Maybe there's a problem with the tape.
Yeah. Hopefully not. I guess we'll have to find out when we get to it. But yeah, I'm going to get ready to call someone McDonald's. I'm going to go through this thing.
Did you play the commercial? Sometimes you play the commercial.
Yeah, I thought I did. I don't really remember yesterday. Do you remember yesterday? I gotta remember day to day anymore.
No, I was born yesterday, so...
Yeah.
I'm now alive today, now that I was born. At nighttime yesterday. Now, I'm trying to follow my own logic and I'm blowing my head up. Kabooey!
I don't remember day to day.
Mushroom cloud. Boom!
Maybe I should try to remember more things. Because then
yeah,
we can, like,
it's irrelevant.
It might help from yesterday to today, though, you know?
Yeah, well. But the person keeps on changing. Yeah!
I have this. Let's play the final dice game.
Yeah, let's work on doing that. And dude.
Yes. Yes. What are you doing here? What are you doing? Is somebody out there? What? Someone's down there. Who is it? They're walking back and forth. Are they trying to talk to us?
I don't know that they're trying to talk to us.
What are they doing out there?
I don't know what they're doing.
They're just. They don't know who you are. Maybe they should mind their own business. We should mind their own business. Yeah? Oh! What are you up? Alright, here we
go. So,
are they yelling? I can't hear it.
No, they're not. Oh. They're talking amongst one another or something.
They're just hanging out.
Just hanging out.
Doing their own thing. Here it is. Oh yeah, no, yeah. 6-5-4-1-6-1. So it's like
six is one. No, one's and six.
Nepitha and Dave.
Either side of the aisle. Let's take a look at them.
In the corners.
In the corners. Whoops. The prior commercial.
Oh, from yesterday.
Yeah. So that's what it was. Oh, it's the other commercial. Hello, Dave. And hello, the bus. Yeah.
All right, here it goes. I'm going to try to call these McDonald's.
Let's do it, bro. Or dog.
Let's do it, bro. I mean dog.
Dog? Oops. Yeah.
Don't call me bro, I'm dog.
Yeah.
Don't call me dog, bro.
Don't call you Charlie.
Don't call me bro, dog.
Yeah, okay.
I'll
call you by your name.
Is it going?
Kenrick, sir. Not my full name!
Don't call me bro, dog!
Well.
Ring a ding ding, McDonald's! Come on, what's it doing?
I don't know.
It's a call error.
I need to get my secret agent earpieces on. Secret agent, man!
Secret agent earpieces!
Yeah. The wolf has left the chicken coop.
Where'd they go?
I don't know.
Hello, McDonald's.
Kind of putting that on the down. Mentioning something about, you know, boxes as well or something.
It should
like
be
that.
Open still.
I don't know. Are you on air?
Are you there? Voicemail, McDonald's, something? I don't know what's going on with that McDonald's. Call the next one.
Are you disappointed that Hillary Street seems to be doing so well in the polls, at least for in one from one pollster?
Well, Donald's winning right now.
Yeah.
With 1 point.
That's right. It doesn't matter what's on the TV. Is the real TV. It's the real TV.
Yeah.
That we need to follow, not the.
I don't really understand what these points are and stuff either.
Well, they're just. And
like
the random people are like saying, I'm voting for Hillary. No, I'm voting for Trump.
Are these?
I don't know.
I don't really get how it works. Why don't we get his vote multiple times and like have a vote now? And
are we gonna roll multiple times?
No, but is everybody just gonna vote? They're gonna say, "Hey, I'm gonna vote. I'm voting."
Well, the, you know that's what I think. You know, the CNN or whatever people out there are doing, to certain candidates' numbers, you know, making them more inflated. You know, like you don't want to vote for a loser. Vote for a winner. Vote for Hillary. That's not what they're saying, but that's the suggested message that is going through.
So you like Trump now?
No.
I said that already. But if you don't like, against, hello? That's what I said. Hey, McDonald's, do you guys have those orange milkshakes yet? Arctic orange?
Orange?
Yeah.
No, we don't.
Oh, do you know when they're going to show up? Because I heard they're going to be coming out in the summertime.
Oh, I really don't know.
No, maybe like there's no calendar or something?
No, we only have the strawberry, vanilla, and chocolate.
It's like the regular ones, yeah. But there's no signs or something?
No.
Oh. Okay.
Okay.
That was abrupt, I guess.
That was abrupt?
Abrupt. Abrupt.
Abrupt.
Abrupt.
What was it, abrupt?
It could have talked to him more. She said, okay, bye, and then went.
We should have kept going with it.
Yeah, she thought that that's the only thing you ever wanted to know was about milkshakes.
I had more things to know.
Yeah, like, how's your hotcakes doing today, their hotcakes?
Oh, Jesus.
You're so bad at this, Carl. I know! That's the best part.
What's up, McDonald's?
Hi, McDonald's. Do you guys have orange milkshakes yet?
What was that, I'm sorry?
I'm waiting to get the Arctic orange milkshakes. I heard they're coming out in the summertime. Do you know when you're going to get them?
I don't, actually. I'm not sure that we have any indication that we were going to be getting them here anytime soon, at least our store specifically.
Mm-hmm.
Looking at our product releases, I'm not even showing it on the listing for this year.
Oh, yeah? You have a computer with what's coming out?
We have a product listing that comes out, you know, updated every month.
Oh, really?
What's
on there right now? What else is on there for the future?
Right now, it looks like we're looking at an Oreo milkshake by the end of the year, but we're not 100% certain exactly the release date for that.
So, all the way throughout the year? Huh? That's a long time. But it can't be while the eggnog milkshake is out, though, so it has to be before eggnog, right? And that's like this November, so it's got to be in like September or October.
That is a possibility. I'm not 100% certain. Unfortunately, I can only provide the information that's provided to me.
Yeah, and that's Oreo, like, you guys have Oreo McFlurries, right? So maybe they're just going to put, well, you just put some of that McFlurry into an Oreo milkshake anyway.
I'm not 100% certain for you. That might be a possibility.
Maybe I could just
I've never made it one yet.
I could just get some of that Oreo, because you guys got the Oreos from McFlurry. Maybe I can just get a vanilla milkshake, and you can just put some of those Oreos from the McFlurry in the milkshake.
Potentially, yeah, you can do that.
It'll be pretty much like a Oreo milkshake, but can you put the milkshake in the McFlurry machine? You know how the machine has that spinny deal?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you can I put the milkshake in there?
Ooh. Are you talking about putting in the McFlurry mixer?
Yeah.
We could, but that would make a large mess.
Oh, yeah. Maybe I'll just let the McFlurry melt a little bit. Or put some milk in it. I'll just put some milk in it. And you guys got milk. I can get a McFlurry and some milk in a cup and then mix them together.
Yeah, potentially you could do that.
That sounds like a good idea to me. I think I'm going to try that one.
All right.
All right, thank you very much.
Absolutely.
Yeah. No. Jesus. Carl.
I'm sorry.
Are you? Are you?
Well.
Jeez.
What do people usually?
We're not gonna be allowed to watch this stuff anymore, Carl. It's getting weird. Like these people are. But my last name.
Come on, my last name.
What? Molester?
No, Bond.
Oh Jesus.
I just don't have an Austin Martin.
Oh, is somebody yelling?
Yeah.
Hello? Oh, he can't hear them yelling because we got headphones on.
Sorry.
I think they weren't yelling at us, so I'm pretty sure they're just yelling out the door to anybody.
Oh, and here. I don't drink anything that's shaken, not stirred.
What?
I don't know what's the difference between shaking and... I mean, I could look.
You don't know what the difference between shaking and stirring is?
Well, I do know, but, you know, the difference between drinks, you know.
One is shaken and one stirred. What do you know, they put it in a martini shaker?
Yeah.
And then they shake it.
Yeah.
And then, or you can put like a spoon in it and you can stir it.
Yeah, but you shake it up, it's kind of like you're moving things around, whether it's shaking or stirring.
Yeah, but he wants to shake and not stir.
Oh.
They're very similar, but maybe it's a subtle difference, and it's not, he knows the subtle differences. That's what makes it
How about if you cram it with a mallet? What will that do to the drink?
Well, it would do something else probably. I want it crammed, not shaken.
Cram it.
Don't shake it or stir it. That's what you would say. Martini.
They'll probably cram me out of the tavern.
Or crammed!
Or the nightclub or whatever.
Carl's gonna be the spy.
Oh, damn it. Yeah. It was 1 and 6, bro. David.
This day, Monday. Every Monday, Carl. YDHWM.com. Check it out.
I'm not in there every Monday.
360-836-4384. Call me a message. Get on TV. Call me on the crew. Bird, Christine, Colette, Dale, Dave, Dick, James,
every day,
Kevin,
Carl.
Mark, Micah, Redbird, River, Tony, Zilger. 360-836-4384. Call me a message. Get on TV. Yeah. TCTV, LeBebe, Jordy, E. Fabulous, Supperback.com, Brown, Webster, Thurston County, Washington State, Graham, USA, viewers only, hell yeah, dog!
Later!
Bye.
Woof.
Coming up on the next episode of the program!
Woo!
Your daily out with me.
Yeah, look, it's Tuesday, August 9th.
We talked to a neighbor of Supper Club, and we're going to Eastern Washington?
In November, maybe.
Whoa!
Vince is trying to quit cigarettes. He said he was going to yesterday, but he still didn't. Carl didn't, wasn't, we're doing the multiple Carl thing in the beginning of the episodes now? For a while?
Yeah.
Check it out. It's going to be a good time. We're on overnight 11:30 to 8 on TV Channel 22, and on the internet. YDHWM, 368-362-384, call your message, get on TV,
.com.
by 2017.
.com.
No, you don't need to do it.